From Gumatch Land on the Gove Peninsula into the great unknown.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
It's the first time NASA has launched a rocket from a commercial space centre outside of the United States and the first ever commercial launch in Australia. Space exploration now an economic driver for traditional owners as mining makes way.
I see a future that looks positive for us. One, that's one. And also I see a positive side in the transit of Nhulunbuy, especially when, the post-mining, when the mining company goes. Arnhem Space Centre here is the way to go.
75 of NASA's finest spent weeks on site preparing for the maiden launch. Despite rain and wind delaying the takeoff for about an hour, experts say Arnhem Land is the perfect platform to send rockets into space.
Its uniqueness around how remote it is, the fact that it's really close to the equator means that that rocket companies can save fuel in getting their payloads into orbit much faster. And there's very little maritime or air traffic in the region, which is perfect conditions if you're looking to launch a rocket.
And the sight of rockets hurtling into space from Arnhem Land is set to become a lot more common. Two more launches are planned over coming weeks, and that's just the beginning. There's already plans to expand the Arnhem Space Centre, and in the not-too-distant future, there could be multiple rocket launches happening each week.
It provides such an enormous opportunity, I think, for the Northern Territory and for Arnhem Land in particular, for the people here and the community here. Space and science and exploration seems like it's something that they're really in touch with and will create enormous economic opportunities for them.
If I was to go into space myself, I'd be singing that song, David Bowie song. I'd be like Major Tom. Except I'm not.
A small step for space exploration, a giant leap for Arnhem Land.
3, 2, 1, go!
Guy McLean, SBS World News.